From Tampa Bay streaming news leader, this is ABC Action News.
I'm Vanessa Ariza. You can expect a scorcher today. Greg D has your full weather forecast coming up. But first, here are your ABC Action News headlines. Pasco County Schools is taking action over the growing violence occurring at 5A High School. Deputies say at least two fights broke out yesterday. The administration says it will begin issuing harsher punishments.
We will not tolerate this violent and disruptive behavior. The fighting and the posting of fights at 5A needs to stop now.
Anyone fighting will now get an automatic 10-day out-of-school suspension and possibly face criminal charges. A student could also get expelled, and if someone records the fight, they could get suspended up to 5 days. There's a new effort underway to properly memorialize more than 100 people buried under a Tampa apartment complex. Ground-penetrating radar found 120 coffins at the Robles Park Village complex. The site was Tampa's first segregation-era burial ground. Florida Senator Jana Cruz is calling for a task force to identify the remains buried there. Lawyers for the Parkland shooting suspect are trying to get the lead prosecutor thrown off the case. They want the judge to remove Broward County State Attorney Mike Satz and his entire office because Satz won't even consider taking the death penalty off the table, despite mitigating factors. No word on when a judge could make a decision on this. TECO customers could see a slightly smaller power bill next year. Tampa Electric filed a proposal to drop rates by 1%, citing lower natural gas prices and increased use of solar energy. The state has to approve that proposal. As we drive Tampa Bay forward, we are addressing one of your top complaints to our tip line. Drivers are encountering backups, gridlocks on Sims Road in southern Hillsborough County. Now, Sims is only one of three east-west connectors in the Riverview area. A charter school opened last month, which could be adding more traffic. Drivers tell us they are frustrated.
You get a little bit anxiety. You know, your kids get worked up in the car. You're trying to get them to school.
And every year, the traffic just gets worse and worse with all of the building that's going on.
County Commissioner Sandra Merman says Sims Road is now on a funded list of projects. The plan is to tweak stop lighting timing, add roundabouts at three intersections, and eventually add two lanes in each direction. And we are listening to your tips as we drive Tampa Bay forward. Let us know about traffic issues you see in your neighborhood impacting your everyday life. You can email us at driving@wfts.com. Let's get a look at your weather with Greg D.
And Vanessa, this afternoon, it's all about the heat. As you mentioned, it's the heat index. Heat advisories are up. High temperatures will be in the 90s, but I really want you to stay inside and focus on keeping cool because the combination of heat, very little rainfall, and lots of sun is going to push our heat index to 105 to 108 degrees, and that could put a strain on your body if you do have to work outside. Maybe move that workout inside or reschedule for later in the day. You can always get your latest hour-by-hour forecast by downloading the ABC Action News app. Vanessa?
Greg, thank you. And you can now get your news all day long on your favorite streaming device. Just download the free ABC Action News app on Roku, Amazon Fire TV, Android TV, and Apple TV.